You should be doing more with your phone. All right, here's the deal. Your phone is a computer. Phone is probably one of the least used apps on your pocket computer. So when we look at increasing phone prices and we see these marketing slides about ever more powerful mobile processors, we should be looking at ways to get more practical use out of our phones and hopefully replace some of the need for other computers in our general sphere of tech. I'm totally spoiled by dual display phones. We've got mobile multitasking on steroids, but there's a feature I find a lot of regular phone owners overlook: split screen. We've had some flavor of this feature since the early generations of Galaxy Notes and early LGs. Remember when we thought the Note was freakishly big? How quaint. Now, huge phones are the norm. But while Android now natively supports split screen, it's not something I see used that often. Instead, we get all excited about picture-in-picture, which is functionally lame compared to split screen. That's one of my favorite things to do on all phones, is keep a video playing at the top of the screen and have another app running down below it. On older phones, that could feel a bit cramped. But currently, this new trend of taller and skinnier phones, it's kind of perfect. Dock a video to the upper quarter of the screen, and you've got roughly a 15:9 aspect ratio underneath. And the video really does stay out of your way. You don't have that dopey postage stamp video, which is like floating on top of and constantly right where you'd want to use something on an app. Picture in picture is lame. I don't like it. The issue with split screen is conveyance. I think Google's done a pretty terrible job drawing users to this functionality. You just have to magically know that if you long press on the name of an app in multitasking view, you get an option to use split screen. And for the apps that don't officially support that feature, you have to know how to force enable it in developer options. It'd be like expecting Windows PC owners to edit their registry just so they could have two programs on the screen at the same time, and then hiding all of the controls for minimizing and maximizing windows behind a right-click menu option. Google could definitely make this clearer, but Android manufacturers have been making this nicer to use. I get really excited to see app pairs and auto-launching on folding phones and dual displays, but there's no reason not to have this kind of function on regular phones. As a brief aside, I gotta give some props to Sony for embracing this and including it in their custom menu and custom UI. If we're going to spend more on a phone, we should get more use out of it. Have you been showing your family and friends split screen? What apps do you like to pair together? Drop some comments down below. Let's have a chat. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos, and subscribing to the channel. Supporting your favorite content creators has never been more important than it is today. So I greatly appreciate those of you who really do scan through the links down in the description or check out my merch. There's the support page on somegadgetguy.com for a current list of all my affiliates and partnerships. Or you might consider joining the list of names scrolling by on your screen. That's from my Patreon, patreon.com/somegadgetguy. Those are basically the coolest people on the web, so I hope you'll check them out. Now, you know where you can find me around the rest of the internet, at somegadgetguy on the Twitters and the Twitch, and the Facebooks and the Instagrams. And I will catch you all on the next video.